entrance is on the right, just here.
Because our eyewitnesses that were sent to the gas chambers too, they were replaced again by prison. What was going on in the yard. On this place there was execution wall. Several thousand prisoners were executed here. People were left on the block number 11. Naked, barred, or punished responsibility. One escaped, 10 or more punished. You will see starvation cell number 18. The same important cell for Catholics, because in this cell, among the others, was Polish priest, Father Maximilian Kolder. You know history?
Mm-hmm.
All of you? During evening roll call, one prisoner was chosen to death in starvation cell. He started to cry loudly. Father Kolder decided to come. 90 by 90 centimeter like opening for fresh air, 5x5 cover outside the building, tightened on both sides of the in the first washroom, women had to undress before the execution. In the next one, men, smaller groups, were executed live in the workroom through that door prematurely leading to the execution wall. And from this place was only downstairs.
On the opposite side of the guards room, the guards used to sit in the room 24 hours a day. They supervised the prisoners in the camp prison, which was in the basement. According to survivors, in one night, one round, sometimes one, two, three prisoners.
The seasons, but SS men who supervised prisoners within that watchtower protected from cold, rain, snow, wind. The camp kitchen, beside the camp kitchen, camp orchestra was playing German melodies, usually marches for prisoners who went out to work outside of the camp or returning. The same, men's, women's camp orchestras were established at Birkenau. Majority of the prisoners were employed outside of the camp at the gate. They were counting. It was easier to count them because they had to march to the beat of the music. Nazi supplied wooden barracks. Part of the wooden barracks were dismantled by the Germans before the liberation. They were sent to another camp and used again. Part of the wooden barracks were dismantled after the war before the museum was established and moved to Warsaw. Warsaw was partly resistant and there were people needed shelter and some barracks were sent to
Warsaw. Only chimneys left, foundations. You can see chimneys sticking out from the ground. There were wooden barracks. In 1940,
kind of
right
either.
Wooden barracks were for the German army. During the second, they were moved here in pieces and constructed by the prisoners. In the barracks that is crowded, 400 people, sometimes more. The number depends on the overall number of prisoners in the...
Two were burned up by the Nazis and one by the Sonderkommander. This is where I have the flowers and everything planted so people don't realise what they're getting into. And the trees are to keep it covered from the rest of the camp. God. Thank you. The other thing is, I'm actually standing here by myself. I thought it would be crowded with tourists. I know it's out of season, but the nearest person is Eddie over there. Here I am at the entrance to one of the gas chambers. It's very... I'm quite nauseous, actually. Horrible. Trees around to cover it so no one could see. Awful. No. Do you want to walk back down the central selection ramp?
What, along the railway tracks?
Yeah. No, I don't mean on the tracks itself, I mean this ramp. I didn't mean on the track, that would be daft. So this is the, what they call the Juden platform. This is where the trains either side unloaded, and the selections were done right where I'm walking. And watching this back at home, it's going to seem a million miles and a lifetime away. Don't. Just don't.
I said, stop. I said, I want vegetarian. She said, well, I'll make it. I said, yep.